It may not be the most glamorous work, but pre-harvest scouting is a great way to get into the field to assess culmination of your year's hard work. Walking fields and mapping production issues is an incredibly important source of invaluable data for upcoming years. Pre-harvest scouting allows farmers to identify areas of disease soybeans, potential planting issues, lodging, droughty areas, and especially weeds. Mapping these areas provides a record and a roadmap for action in subsequent years. It's difficult to select varieties, herbicides, insecticides, fungicides, or other management practices without knowing what issues were encountered the previous year. Likewise, it's difficult to interpret yield maps after harvest without good knowledge of variations in the crop and weeds in the field. Mapping weedy areas to fields provides many benefits. Maps can be used to monitor weed pressure in fields over time to evaluate various programs and progress in battles with weeds. Maps allow for spot spraying of troublesome areas in subsequent years. Maps can serve as a reference when returning to the field to manually remove weeds before harvest. And maps can help combine operator avoid areas of dense weeds. It's critical to reduce the number of weeds that enter the combine during harvest. Most weeds will produce from hundreds to hundreds of thousands of viable seeds each. Each seed could end up in the weed seed bank within the field. Harvested weeds are also likely to lead to weed seed contaminating the harvested soybeans. Those seeds that do not enter the grain tank will get distributed throughout the field. Today's combine spread plant material over an extremely wide area, and weed seeds tend to get hung up in combines. So harvesting equipment can become weed distribution implements if weeds aren't properly managed.
One of the situations that sometimes farmers are dealt with is weed control populations that occur the previous year. And in this situation, we have a soybean field that had a fair to moderate amount of weeds, particularly giant ragweed. It was combined in the field the previous year with a 30-foot header. But then we ended up with a concentration of weeds due to weed seed positioning right behind the combine. And this oftentimes is a situation that complexes farmers' weed control practices in the following year, where they have concentrated weed populations. It's difficult for herbicides to control in a population of various heights of the weeds. And of course, it contributes to the weed seed bank. So with the concern here, it may be a weed problem in one year, but behind the combine and concentrated like this, it could be a problem for many years to come.
So here we are in a soybean field looking at the field edge, and here we have a pretty large population of giant ragweed that is obviously kind of encroaching into this field here. We're standing about four or five rows in, and you can see, especially within that four or five rows, the giant ragweed is pretty thick in that area. Giant and common ragweed especially are weeds that do tend to encroach from the field edges. So when we talk about either long-term weed management or FM management in soybeans, you know, these field edges are a lot of times where weed populations come from. Certain weeds, especially the ragweeds, are especially problematic on these field edges. So if we think about managing, you know, either short or long term for these weed populations, if we can do anything to manage these field edges, you know, even if it is coming in with a mower late season here, we're standing in late August. If we come through and mow these outside four rows of soybeans, that's obviously going to eliminate that seed production, at least from entering in the field further. The issue we a lot of times will see is when you're combining a soybean field, that soybean head reaches out to the outside of the field, pulls in this weed seed, goes into the combine, and it slowly works its way further out into the field. Now we're standing in a field too that's already had this happen, so we do have a number of different ragweed plants that have encroached even further into that field. And as we start to manage these longer, about 3 or 4 years down the road, these edge weeds will make their way really into that entire field, which makes managing these weed populations much more challenging, as well as managing that FM from those weed seeds a little bit more challenging as well. So one of the issues we have with whether they're fence line weeds or weeds out in the middle of the field, especially for some of the pigweeds, like here we have a female water hemp plant that certainly does have viable seeds already. A lot of times when I am curious if a weed has produced viable seed, if you tap that seed head in your hand and there's any darker seeds, you have a pretty good confidence level that there are some viable seeds. So this plant, if you were to pull it, you really should pull it up, bag it, and remove it from that field, or otherwise those seeds will be there in that seed bank going forward. A female water hemp plant has a lot of potential to produce seed. Most of the pigweeds, you know, have, with these small seeds, are able to produce thousands and thousands of seeds per plant, especially if they're large and don't have a lot of competition going through those. So bagging those plants, getting those seeds out of that field and away from that weed seed bank is really going to be the key. Say you do have water hemp seeds that are in that seed bank, really 90% of those weed seeds can be depleted in about 3 years or so. 4 years, you can get closer to 95%+ of those weed seeds degraded from the seed bank. So anything you can do to prevent seed production, prevent those weed seeds from going back into that soil seed bank, will help manage that weed population going forward. So here we're looking at another common weed problem in soybeans, which of course is volunteer corn. Volunteer corn certainly is a problem for a few different reasons. Number one, from an FM standpoint, certainly this crop seed, the ears that are produced on this volunteer corn will end up typically in the combine and cause some issues there. It's also a problem from corn rootworm management and other pest management, where if we do have these volunteer corn plants, we are able to get sort of a green bridge between years, and we actually can reduce that rotation effect, where rotating out of corn might not be quite the advantage you're thinking of, because we do have this volunteer corn site for those corn rootworms to feed and basically extend their presence in this field into next year when we're going to be rotating back to corn. So regardless, whether it's from an FM standpoint or really a crop rotation management standpoint, you know, getting rid of this volunteer corn, controlling these populations will still be an important factor in your weed control management program. All right, so here we're standing in a relatively clean soybean field, but we do have a little weed patch out here. So when we think about really spreading these weed seeds around, or from an FM standpoint, contaminating that soybean sample, you know, this is a situation where we might want to consider either mowing this patch down if it's small and easy to get to, or even driving around it with the combine, because as soon as you run one of these weed patches through a combine, really that combine is an excellent weed seed spreader, and those weed populations will spread throughout that field. So if you do have these relatively small patches, or even hand weed those if they are relatively small before you get into that combine, as soon as you get into that combine cab, it does tend to be difficult to drive around some of these patches. So really anything you can do to manage these patches before you get into that combine really will definitely work benefits for you.
Keeping weeds out of the combine may require additional management, but compared to dealing with tough-to-control weeds for years to come, early effort will certainly pay off.